Okay, so now we're going to show you, again, in the web-based program, once you've completed the work order, how to create the invoice from that screen, okay? On your phone, the work order and the creation of the invoice all happens on the same page, on the same screen. But when you're logged in online, you actually have to go into the invoices screen here. And it's going to show you all of your not prepared work orders. So I have this one that I just completed in the last video, and I'm going to go ahead in here and click on the work order. It's going to take me to the invoice screen. Okay. So I can change the invoice status. Again, I can say prepared or approved. Once you mark it as prepared, that means that it has to be reviewed. Once it's approved, that tells it that it's okay to flow down to QuickBooks Financial. So I'm just going to say this is a status is approved. I have the invoice date, so if I need to date at the end of the month or the first of the month, I can change that there. You can select a class for this invoice, and it pulls up your class list. And the PO number flows through from the work order that we entered there. You do have an option or a time here where you can review the work done description. So if there's anything in here that needs to be changed, spelled correctly, whatever it is, you can edit that and change it. Then we can go down here and add some charges. All right, so we're going to add search for service. We're going to add the service agreement, okay? And we're going to say completed monthly service, whatever it is, our custom description. We can change the rate. We can change the quantity. So if it's $150 an hour and we spent 4 hours, it'll total it up there. Let's say this is a non-taxable because it's all labor. I can change that. It's going to default to what I have in QuickBooks as this item's taxable or non-taxable. You can apply a discount to this item or if you had multiples. So let's go ahead and add a big pen. Okay. So I can add a big pen and say, oh, we just give a discount on the big pen, and it's going to be 10% discount. So it just gives me 10% off of that big pen rather than, and let's go ahead and put on here 10 of them. So it'll give me a discount just on that big pen versus giving me a discount on the agreement and the big pen. Okay. Is a discount before or after sales tax? So I'm saying it's before sales tax. I have the sales tax rate that was set up for this customer, but I can change it on the fly. And then I can go ahead and say save. Okay. Now, if in the field we did have the technicians taking payment, I'm going to go pull my approved invoices here, take a look at it here, and I can take a payment right there at the time. So I can say they're paying cash or check, who the check's received by, Mary Smith, the check number, and any memo in here. And all this information, again, is going to flow through into QuickBooks. So the invoice will be marked as paid, and this 708.45 will be sitting in our undeposited funds. Okay. So that is how to create an invoice in Field Service Management.